morning to all of you, and welcome on this Friday morning. And so let us begin, as always, on this this Friday morning in October, in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of His Holy Spirit be with all of you as we prepare to celebrate and to enter into these sacred and profound mysteries. Let's pause for a moment and call to mind all of our sins and ask the Lord for His mercy, His healing, and His forgiveness. Lord Jesus, You are Son of God and Son of Mary. Lord, have mercy. You came to call all of us. Christ, have mercy. And Lord, You plead for each one of us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us all of our sins. Bring us all to everlasting life. O God, who in Your unfathomable providence are pleased to send Your holy angels to guard us, hear our supplication as we cry to You, that we may always be defended by their protection and rejoice eternally in their company, through our Lord Jesus Christ, Your Son, who lives and reigns with You in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Job. The Lord addressed Job out of the storm and said, "Have you ever in your lifetime commanded the morning and shown the dawn its place for taking hold of the ends of the earth till the wicked are shaken from its surface? The earth is changed as is clay by the seal, and died as though it were a garment. But from the wicked the light is withheld, and the arm of pride is shattered. Have you entered into the sources of the sea, or walked about in the depths of the abyss? Have the gates of death been shown to you, or have you seen the gates of darkness? Have you comprehended the breadth of the earth? Tell me, if you know all, which is the way to the dwelling place of light, and where is the abode of darkness? That you may take them to their boundaries and set them on their homeward paths? You know, because you were born before them, and the number of your years is great." Then Job answered the Lord and said, "Behold, I am of little account. What can I answer you? I put my hand over my mouth. Though I have spoken once, I will not do so again. Though twice, I will do so no more." The word of the Lord.
Guide me, Lord, along the everlasting way. Guide me, Lord, along the everlasting way. O Lord, You have probed me and You know me.
You know when I sit and when I stand. You understand my thoughts from afar. My journeys and my rest you scrutinize. With all my ways you are familiar. Guide me, Lord, along the everlasting way. Where can I go from your spirit? From your presence, where can I flee? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I sink to the netherworld, you are present there. Guide me, Lord, along the everlasting way. If I take the wings of the dawn, if I settle at the farthest limits of the sea, even there your hand shall guide me, and your right hand hold me fast. Guide me, Lord, along the everlasting way. Truly, you have formed my inmost being. You knit me in my mother's womb. I give you thanks that I am fearfully, wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works. Guide me, Lord, along the everlasting way.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Jesus said to them, "Woe to you, Chorazin! Woe to you, Bethsaida! For if the mighty deeds done in your midst had been done in Tyre or Sidon, they would long ago have repented, sitting in sackcloth and ashes. But it'll be more tolerable for Tyre and Sidon at the judgment than for you. And as for you, Capernaum, will you be exalted to heaven? You will go down to the netherworld. Whoever listens to you, listens to me. Whoever rejects you, rejects me. And whoever rejects me, rejects the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord. You know, they say that God speaks to us through his incredible coincidences. That's how God winks at us, through his incredible coincidences. And a lot of times we dismiss it, we ignore it, we say, well, that's just a random occurrence. But we've all had this happen. We're worried about something, we're praying over something, and then we'll look at a bumper sticker and it's exactly what we're thinking. Or we'll look at a billboard and it's exactly what we need to hear. Or we'll read the newspaper and we'll read a line that answers our problem. Or we'll talk to somebody in the supermarket and they'll say exactly what we need to hear to answer our problem. We've all experienced that. God speaks anonymously through our coincidences. That's how he lets us know that he's with us. He is Emmanuel. He's with us every step of the way. But it's not just my opinion. Listen to the words of Psalm 139, which might be one of the most beautiful psalms ever composed. You search me, Lord, you know me. You know when I sit and when I stand. You understand my thoughts from afar. Before a word is ever on my tongue, you know it, O Lord, through and through. Isn't that beautiful? Before we sit or stand, before a word is ever on our tongue, God knows it. He created us. He knows our thoughts from afar. And the first reading read so beautifully from the book of Job also talks about the mystery, that that God is all mystery. And we don't have to look too far, we just look at the heavens. You know, I remember reading, and I almost fell out of my chair when I read it. Okay, the Milky Way is one galaxy, right? It's our galaxy, the Milky Way. But you know how many, according to the Hubble telescope, astronomers estimate, you know how many galaxies there are in the universe? 150 billion. Think about that. Whatever our problems are, whatever our worries are, they don't amount to much. Now you say, well, that's nice, Father, 150 billion. Well, you know how much 150 galaxies now? You know, one galaxy, the Milky Way, contains Neptune and the Moon and Venus and Saturn and Mars and the Earth and all the other stars. 150 billion. That number would be, if each galaxy were a frozen pea like you get at Publix, each galaxy was one frozen pea, 150 galaxies would be placing them all in, and they would fill up the old Boston Garden to the top. So we realize that God is God and we're not God. God's ways are far above our ways. And that's why Job is saying, who am I to question you, Lord? Who am I to question your ways? You set the stars in the sky. But maybe the best way to explain it is Theodore Roosevelt, the old Rough Rider. The turn of the century, President Theodore Roosevelt, when he was had a difficult day in the Oval Office, he would go out to the front lawn of the White House, and he would search the stars for the galaxy right behind Pegasus, Andromeda. And he'd say, there is a spiral galaxy, Andromeda. It is as large, it contains as many suns, it contains thousands of suns, each larger than our sun. And he'd tell himself how many millions of light years it is away. And he'd meditate on the distance and the size of Andromeda. And then he'd say to himself, now I think my problems are small enough, and he'd head off to bed. To God, who is infinite and inexhaustible, yet he walks with us every step of the way. Let's humbly approach him with all our needs. Let's pray first and foremost for our president and the first lady and all those who are afflicted with the coronavirus, that they receive the healing hand of Almighty God. Let us pray to the Lord. Let's pray for Ryan and Olivia and the Conley family. For Ryan and Olivia Conley, the Conley family. We pray in a special way for Henry and his late wife, Rosalie. For Marie and her late husband, George. For Rosie and Jerry. For Jean Scott and Cindy and Maggie. For Michael Dana and his wife and his five children. For Fred and Joanne and Fred Jr., for Carolyn Berg, for Grace Liotto, and for Mary Rogers, the Neri family, for Ginger Shannon, for Polly. We pray for Mark Moran and Sally. And Josie and her daughter Denise and her son Paul. And we pray also in a special way for Madeline Gaffey and for the Gaffey family, Madeline, her late husband Jack, and all of you, all your loved ones, all your family members, living and deceased. Let's pause for a moment for those intentions. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sins, now and at the hour. We ask all these prayers in the name of Mary's Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, work of human hands. Become for us the bread of life. Mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, become for us our spiritual drink. Lord, wash away my iniquities, cleanse me of all of my sins. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the offerings we bring before you as we venerate your holy angels and our guardian angels, and graciously grant that under their constant protection we may be delivered from present dangers and harm and brought happily to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. truly right and just, our duty, our salvation, always, everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the beautiful Virgin Mary, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. So now, with all the angels and archangels, with all the martyrs and the saints, with all the seraphim and cherubim, we sing together the song of your glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of our faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Frank our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember, Lord, in a special way, all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with the guardian angels, and all the seraphim and cherubim in the heavenly court, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant us peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all worry and fear and distress as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace is my gift to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, according to your will, live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. May the body of Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Viewing at home the act of spiritual communion, my Jesus, I believe that you are present in this most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Peter, the body of Christ, Peter.
Let us pray.
May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore in us in mind, in body, in spirit, on this feast of your holy guardian angels, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Jesus Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless each one of you and all your loved ones, all your family members, living and deceased, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Have a wonderful weekend. Joseph and Denise. Hello. God bless you. God bless you. Pauline and Patricia. Mr. Conley. God bless you.